77, so no one knew what to call this. And really, by 1982, when new sounds started, we still didn't know what to call it. Especially since the album went through so many different sounds and styles. For me, it was one of the albums that helped define the musical territory that New Sounds would cover. I'm John Schaefer, and tonight on New Sounds, we're going to hear some of this newly reissued classic recording from Aksak Mabul. We'll also hear some of the other projects from the two musicians at the heart of the band, and that will take us to some very unusual musical places as well. Music from Brazil and Ethiopia and the Balkans and beyond. So I hope you'll stay with us. Let's get started in earnest with the first of the album's unexpected segues as this piece, Sarek Gurk, transitions into a little, almost French-style chanson called Milano Percasso from the band Aksak Mabul. Group with an Arabic name. Milano Percasso is the name of the song from the album Onze Danses, or 11 Dances, by the Belgian duo Aksak Mabul. The band was formed by two young musicians, Mark Hollander and Vincent Kenny, both of whom we would go on to hear a lot more from in future years. But back in 1977, they put this band together to just kind of play, I mean, really, just play with sounds and styles. And they chose the name Aksak in Arabic music. When you have odd rhythms, those are known as Aksak, or limping rhythms. And Mabul is a kind of slang term that means crazy. So that was the derivation of the name. Mark Hollander explained it to us many years ago when he visited the New Sound studio back in the late 80s. And as I mentioned a few minutes ago, this album was a kind of central pillar of the New Sound's aesthetic when the show was just getting going. But so were a number of the other things that Mark Hollander would go on to do, because he founded the record label called Cram Discs in Belgium, which has been responsible for a lot of really great music making its way to our ears. And for me, the first kind of major achievement of Cram Discs as a label was in introducing American ears to the idea that Ethiopia might have had a really amazing music scene at one point, which was the late 60s, early 70s. And the way they did that was by issuing, for the first time in this country, the album Ere Mela Mela by the singer Mahmoud Ahmed. This was like a huge discovery for me back in the mid-80s, and this so-called Ethiopique sound would become much more popular and common in the 90s and the aughts, but the folks at Cram Discs were way ahead of the game, and we'll hear the song Abay Mado from Mahmoud Ahmed, the Ethiopian singer, from the Cram Discs recording from 1987.
Mama, the peanut, your head, and the cake, and the head, and the
Iranian singer Mahmoud Ahmed from his album Ere Mela Mela, recorded in Ethiopia in the early 70s and in the mid-80s, in 1987 actually. Mark Hollander's label, Cram Discs, released it in Europe and in these United States. That's how I first discovered this music. Mark Hollander, one of the founders of the band Aksak Mahul. We're hearing some of their recently reissued album, All's Dance. The other co-founder of the band, Vincent Kenny, went on to a career.
She makes it look like she's not, but she is. Okay. She's nosy as hell.
She's like, you just really needed a donut? I'm like, yes, Mom, I need a fucking donut.
I just need a donut.